from Blackearth Minerals is Tom Revy. Tom, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very good, Tom. An important milestone for you, this maiden ESG rating. Tell us a bit more about the significance of the rating and who Digbee ESG are.
Okay, so for those who aren't familiar, ESG stands for basically environmental and social governance issues. Obviously, critically important in terms of the development of any project and sort of evolves over time from exploration through development through operations, ultimately shutting down. I think a lot of people think that it's soft and fluffy, but in reality, it's an integral part of any responsible company's risk mitigation and minimisation strategy. It's always been there. The fundamental difference between, say, 10 years ago and where we are today is the fact that under the ESG push moving forward, it's the need is there to be more transparent. And that has enormous consequences, negative and positive, depending on how you want to move forward. In terms of Digbee ESG themselves, well, they're a unique group and they provide a right-sized and simple approach for the mining sector internationally. And so what they do is they fundamentally provide a very detailed list of questions relating to corporate activities and project-related activities. They assess those with backup information, and at the end of the day, come up with a rating. And we're pleased to announce that we came up with a double B rating.
And what does this rating, Tom, mean for Blackearth shareholders?
It's important. The double B certainly is a very good result for a company in feasibility. Compared to our peers, I think we've done very well at like-for-like development levels. And what it means is that we've provided a transparent report. It's been audited independently. And what I believe will happen and what's tended to happen from what we've seen is that will start to attract ESG funds from around the world who say, you've gone through the process, you understand where you are, what you've done, what you're doing, and most importantly, what needs to be done moving forward. So it's great for shareholders, as it is great for all stakeholders, government, the local villagers, shareholders, etc.
And Tom, you had this news last week, the infill drill program complete at Mineri. What's it revealed? How did it go?
It went very well. There were a couple of cyclones that went through. Thankfully, they had no impact whatsoever in terms of any damage in the area. What it revealed was that we put deeper holes in. So where we had the initial resource and the initial pits going down some 40 metres, our drill holes have gone down to about 80 metres plus and encountered very attractive grades as far as continuation of depth within that reservoir area. So we're very pleased with that. Implications are that it's more than likely that we'll add to our resource at reservoir, and that will be part of the new resource that we'll put out in coming months as part of the feasibility study. The infill drilling also means that the indicated resources will be defined as measured. And of course, measured and indicated resources ultimately become proven and probable reserves once technical and financial aspects are applied. So it's going really well. No surprises. Everything was as planned, only that we've encountered better grades in some areas below the current reservoir resource.
And as you said, Tom, in terms of upcoming news, you're looking to put out that measured resource in the coming months here.
Correct. Yes, we've got quite a bit of news coming through, obviously, in relation to things such as the Indian joint venture, which is going very well. More to talk about that, I'm sure, in coming weeks. The resource, as you say, I'll probably provide a DFS update on the Mineri project as well over the next sort of 4 to 6 weeks, just to keep shareholders in the picture in terms of what's going on. And obviously, there's a raft of other strategic things that we're looking at as well at the moment.
Good to see you, Tom. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.